नमस्कार, नंदुरबार तालुका विधायक समिति कॉलेज ऑफ एजुकेशन नंदुरबार, सब्जेक्ट CPS 3/CPS 4, करिकुलम एंड पेडागॉजिक स्टडीज स्कूल, सब्जेक्ट फर्स्ट इंग्लिश। वी हैव स्टार्टेड यूनिट नंबर 1, एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज। हियर टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न 1.1, स्टेप्स ऑफ टीचिंग प्रोज / पोएट्री। इट मीन्स दैट दो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द प्रोज, बट द सेम स्टेप्स will be followed in poetry too. So prose / poetry is there. In last video we have seen prose, meaning of prose, objective of teaching prose, types of prose, teaching of prose. Now today we will learn steps in teaching prose, and after it we will see methods of teaching prose. So today we are going to learn steps of in teaching prose. It is also called a procedure of teaching prose lesson or poetry lesson. It may be we call it as a steps in teaching prose. When you will prepare the lesson plan, you have to follow these steps to prepare a lesson. It may be on prose, it may be on a poetry. What may be the first step we used as preparation, it is also called an introduction, but we write it as a preparation. Then we mention statement of aim. It is not a step, but we mention in lesson plan as a statement of aim. What it is, we will see. Then we use the second important step, that is presentation. Then after it, recapitulation and practice. We mention it as a practice. We use this word. Then application, we can say it as a product. Generally, we use this word product. And after it, home assignment, we use assignment. So these are the steps. Let us see how these steps and what we have to mention or follow in each step. So let's see in detail steps in teaching. First one is that preparation. Generally, while preparing a lesson plan, in each step we mention activities. Activity first, activity second, activity third, etc. But here we will not discuss about the activities, we just discuss the steps. So the first step is preparation. Here in preparation, preparation includes previous knowledge of the student about the lesson. Suppose whatever the content you are going to introduce, you have to prepare them to introduce a new language. The preparation should be on previous knowledge. It means that त्याने काय अगोदर शिकलेलं आहे, अध्ययन केलेलं आहे त्या टॉपिक संदर्भातलं, त्या कंटेंट संदर्भातलं. दॅट इज कॉल्ड अ प्रिवियस नॉलेज. सो टीचर शुड लिंक इट प्रॉपरली. हियर व्हाट वी हॅव टू डू, वी हॅव टू लिंक प्रिवियस नॉलेज, व्हाट यू आर गोइंग टू टीच देम अ न्यू नॉलेज. That is, we have to link between these two content with previous knowledge. So we have to follow it. Then introduction is followed by previous knowledge of the lesson. It is important part to make the students ready to learn and start the lesson. So as it is believed that well begun is half done, the introduction has two purposes. See, if we started, we begun well, then our lesson will be end in success. That is the proverb, well begun is half done. So it has a two part. Generally, to bring the previous knowledge to consciousness, this is one thing, and second one is that to link the previous knowledge to the new knowledge to be given. So for this purpose we are going to prepare the students, or we are going to use the previous knowledge of them to bring the previous knowledge into consciousness. कधी कधी काय असतं, आपल्याला विद्यार्थ्यांना ते कंटेंट माहीत असतं, परंतु ते त्यांच्या अवबोधावस्थेमध्ये गेलेलं असतं, तर ते बोधावस्थेत आपल्याला ते ज्ञान आणायचं असतं. सो वी हॅव टू ब्रिंग दॅट नॉलेज इन कॉन्शियसनेस. सो टू लिंक द प्रिव्हियस नॉलेज टू द न्यू नॉलेज टू बी गिवन. आणि आपल्याला काय करायचं, नवीन ज्ञान आणि जे अगोदर घेतलेलं ज्ञान, वी हॅव टू लिंक दिस टू थिंग. सो दॅट्स वाय वी प्रिपेअर दॅम. सो इंट्रोडक्शन कॅन बी डन इन डिफरंट वेज. आता हाऊ टू प्रिपेअर how to do the preparation or how to introduce the new content, it may be done in various or different ways. So first way is that the teacher may start by asking some introductory question in order to test the previous knowledge. You may set some questions on previous knowledge and then link it to the topic to be taught. This is the one method. By asking questions on previous knowledge, you may prepare your lesson. Then he may attract the student attention by showing pictures, charts, models, etc. and arouse their curiosity. Kadhi you apan ekada picture, charts, models survatila show karto ani tyanna kaitari ek curiosity nirman hoil navin learning sandarbhatli. That type of curiosity you are going to arose among the students. That is the second way you can use to prepare the introductory step. In the event of continuing lesson, the teacher can ask questions on the portion of the lesson already taught. Suppose you have started this lesson and the half part you have done, then you can ask some questions what you have already taught them. जो भाग झाला असेल अध्यापनाचा त्याच्यावर सुद्धा तुम्ही काही प्रश्न या ठिकाणी विचारू शकता. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ व्हेरियस वेज यू कॅन यूज. यू कॅन सेट अ सॉन्ग टू स्टार्ट. एखादं गाणं जर आपल्याला पोएम जर म्हणता येत असेल एखाद्या कंटेंटशी रिलेटेड, यू कॅन यूज. यू कॅन यूज डिफरंट वेज. इट इज डिपेंड्स ऑन युअर क्रिएटिव्हिटी. Use your creativity to prepare a lesson or to introduce a lesson. That is the first step, that is preparation. In preparation, we have to prepare the student to learn a new language. That's the simple principle behind it. So this is the first step. Let's see the second one, that is statement of aim. This is not a step, but we mentioned in a lesson plan, so it is called as a statement of aim. Here what we do, it should be clear for students' point of view. आज आपण काय विद्यार्थ्यांना शिकवणार आहोत हे विद्यार्थ्यांना क्लिअर झालं पाहिजे. सो इट शुड बी क्लिअर फॉर स्टुडंट्स पॉईंट ऑफ व्ह्यू. दॅट इज द मेन थिंग. अँड अंडर दिस द टीचर क्लिअरली एक्सप्लेन्स द टॉपिक विच ही इज गोइंग टू टीच अँड इन्स्ट्रक्ट द स्टुडंट्स टू ओपन देअर बुक्स ॲट द अप्रोप्रिएट पेज. वॉट वी हॅव टू डू, व्हॉट यू आर गोइंग टू टीच, इट शुड बी क्लिअर टू द स्टुडंट्स. And you should mention the page number, what page number you are going to teach. So it should be as, the statement should be like this. So today we are going to learn a story, a poem, a lesson, so and so its name. That's type of statement of aim we have to prepare here. So this is the second one, statement of aim. So third step is that presentation. In presentation is the important step, or it is the main part of the lesson plan. So the lesson may be divided into two or more units. So the following sub steps are followed in each unit. So the first one is that what we have to do in presentation. First, suppose it is on a reading skill, then a reading allowed by the teacher should be there. So while preparing the lesson plan on a prose lesson, so we should be read aloud by the teacher. There should be reading by the teacher. Reading allowed by the teacher is called model reading. So model reading should be presented before the students. Then second one, we can follow it as a pronunciation drill. Pronunciation drill should precede reading aloud. The words should be selected on the basis of the pronunciation skill of the class. So the selected words should be written on the blackboard one by one and practice. So those words are selected which are difficult to pronounce by the students. So while selecting the words, we have followed this rules. They should be difficult for the students in which class you are going to teach. According to that class, you have to select the words. So they should, that word should be difficult for that student to pronounce. So commonly mispronounced by the student, sometimes some words are commonly mispronounced, so that word should be selected by us. So containing the silent letter, some words have some silent letter, so we should select those words to for this activity, pronunciation drill. So this is the this step is followed by reading aloud. So again, in presentation, reading loud by the student, sometimes we ask the student to read the passage. It is important to develop a reading comprehension, so we may ask students to read aloud. So while asking this activity, what we have to keep in mind, that the teachers ask some students to read the passage aloud by one, aloud one by one. So you may ask 3 to 4 students to read line by line. So loud reading by the student is also called imitation reading, as they try to imitate the teacher's pronunciation, pause and intonation. So when teacher reads the passage, he should follow the pronunciation, pause, intonation pattern, etc. So that type of reading is a model reading for the student. So when we ask students to read aloud, it means that they are going to imitate the teacher. So they are following that type of pronunciation, pause, intonation pattern, etc. That is the reading aloud by the student. Then exposition of new words, phrases. This is another important activity while in presentation. Here the teacher selects the new words and phrases from the passage and explains their meaning. What we have to do here, we have to select some 3 or 4 new words from this passage, and we have to introduce them before teaching the passage. The teacher selects these words and phrases and from the passage and explains their meaning. Then the meaning should be explained in different way. The teacher can adopt different methods for explaining the meaning. The first one is that by showing the object. Sometimes you can show the model, sometimes you can show the picture, or sometimes you can show the chart. By showing any kind of these things, you can introduce the word. This is the one thing. Then by using the word in a sentence, sometimes you are not able to show a object, model, picture or chart, but you can use that word in a sentence. That may be you can use, for example, suppose it is a fifth class student, you are going to introduce the table word, so you can show the table. It is generally available in the class. Chair is there, so such type of you can show. But sometime it is not possible to show any object, model, picture or chart, so that time you can use a sentence pattern. You can use that word in a sentence and you introduce. So by giving synonyms, antonyms, sometimes students know another word for the same meaning, so you can give that synonyms to them and you can introduce the word. So sometimes you must introduce some antonym to the, that words, and you can introduce. So selecting different types of methods of introducing the word. By drawing a sketch or figure on the blackboard, sometimes students know partial meaning of that word, so you can hint them, you can draw a sketch on a blackboard what the meaning it may be, so students may guess the meaning and they will learn it. So by drawing a sketch or figure on the blackboard, you may introduce. By showing action or gestures, sometimes you show the actions, sometimes you show the gestures, and you can introduce the words. So by translating the word in mother tongue, sometimes if we have difficult to introduce it, then we can give the meaning of that word in mother tongue. So these are the different methods of introducing new words, new phrases before to telling the meaning or before introducing the content. So this is the important activity in presentation. Then presentation followed silent reading. After exposition of new words, phrases, the teacher asks the student to read the passage silently. This helps to students to learn rapid reading. So, silent reading is very important for the students' point of view, because we have to develop among them a reading comprehension. For that purpose, if we have to develop a rapid reading habit, then we may ask a silent reading. Then, learning of new words and quick grasp of meaning. Suppose, if you ask silent reading, the students read the passage and try to grasp the meaning from the passage without knowing the new words, etc. They are going to take the meaning between the context. So, that type of habit is developed among them. So, learning of new words and quick grasp of meaning is very important for them. Then, adequate time should be given to complete the reading of the passage. When we introduce, we ask the student to read this silently, it means that we give them adequate time, we should give them adequate time for complete this activity. So, complete the reading of the passage, given a adequate time to for the reading. That is very important thing. Then, comprehension questions are there. After the silent reading, some question based on the passage should be asked to asked to test students' comprehension of the passage. When you ask the silent reading to the student, then you should ask some important questions on the text, what they are going to read. So, asking questions, it means that you are going to test the comprehension of the student. The following types of question may be asked. So, कोणते प्रश्न विचारले पाहिजे, this is very important thing. First one is that by asking meanings of new words, you may ask the students some meaning of new words from that passage. You may ask by asking short questions on the main portion of the passage. You can ask some main question or short questions on the portion you have to ask to read. You can ask to pick out different forms of words or phrases. This is another very important activity. You may ask the student to pick out different forms of words or phrases. So, you can develop the comprehension of the student by doing such activity. So, that is in preparation. So, in preparation, we have to follow all this thing. We have to introduce the words, then we have to loud reading, then we have to silent reading, then we have to set comprehension questions, and then we have to explain the passage what you have select to introduce. Then you may explain in detail the passage, that is in presentation. Now, the next step is that recapitulation, that is practice. We mentioned in lesson plan as a practice. So, the practice stage is very important one. The purpose of recapitulation is to evaluate the extent to which the objectives of the lesson have been achieved. Here, what we have to do, what we have set the objectives of the lesson, we have to evaluate whether that objective we have to achieve or not. The recapitulation is generally done with different types of question. Here we set some different types of question on the topic we have selected to teach. The question should be from all the passages taught in different units. So in that unit or in that lesson, whatever topic you have introduced, you can set the question through all that topic. So these questions are on the comprehension. All this question on the level of comprehension, it means that they may test the comprehension skill of the student. That is recapitulation or practice stage. We have to set the question, and then next stage step is that application, that is we mentioned in lesson plan as a product. Here product in the sense that after learning all these things, what we have, you have to select the for the lesson, student should be able to use that knowledge or to apply that knowledge in a new situation, or he may be product create some word sentence using that knowledge. That is the main basic idea behind it, application and product. So this step is for the practice to apply the knowledge learned from the lesson. The questions are different from comprehension question. The questions can be as follow: fill in the blanks, match the column, complete the line, choose the correct answer, etc. Synonyms and antonyms is there. It is according to the lesson what you have to select. So these activities can be done in product. So it is used in application of the knowledge what you have learned. And the last stage is that is home assignment. Home assignment is very important. At the end of the lesson, we should provide some assignment to the student. That assigning homework is the final stage of a lesson plan. So home assignment is the basis for retaining learning. When we provide a assignment or home assignment to student, it means that we are trying to retaining the learning. So it can be given in different forms. Assignment can be given in different ways or different forms. First one is that use the new words in their sentence. Suppose you have introduced some new words, you can ask them to write the sentences using such words. You can provide such type of assignment. Make a list of words related with a particular group or topic. Suppose the topic is on a forest, you can ask them to write the words related with the forest in the passage. So it depends on your creativity. So remember the spellings of new words. You can ask the student to remember the spellings on that topic, but or whatever the spellings you have introduced or new words you have introduced. Write the answer of the given question. You can give some questions to answer them. You can ask them to write the answer of that question. Some project work may also be given. Suppose the topic is on a you can provide a project on that topic. You may ask to complete that project. So it is a variation to provide an assignment. So home assignment is the last stage and it is very important. Here today what we have seen the stages of prose lesson or poetry lesson. This whatever the presentation I have prepared, I have used these books and these websites. I have took some references from these books and textbooks. So you can refer these websites and textbooks to learn in detail the steps of lesson plan. So I think you may understood what we have to see here. So if you have any question, you may ask me on LMS. Thank you very much.